1967, and we were sent to just north of the Sinai Peninsula to monitor the traffic between Soviet bombers that were being used by the Egyptians, but we think were manned by the Soviets. We had Israeli flights over about seven times in the morning, identifying us as an American ship. And then about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, two lone jets came and started up our starboard side about a couple miles out. And we thought it would just be another circling of the ship by Israeli aircraft. But instead, they peeled off immediately to the left and scraped us from stem to stern. We just hit the deck when we saw the guns slashing off of their wings in the nose of the aircraft. Somebody threw the general quarters alarm, and everybody went to general quarters and just hid. There's nothing we could do with the air attacks. We only had 450 caliber machine guns. The initial aircraft were Israeli Mirage aircraft, knocked out our communications and our defensive capabilities, put rockets inside each gun tub and inside each antenna mount. And then after the air attack came the slower speed aircraft with napalm and cannons and rockets, and they dropped napalm canisters on us, trying to drive us below decks. After that, the torpedo boats came, fired five torpedoes at us. One of them struck our starboard side. Luckily, it hit an I-beam, so it didn't go all the way into the ship. It exploded almost on contact, but it blew a 25-by-10 hole in our side and killed the 25 people down below. And all told, there were 34 killed, and the last count, 174 wounded. Immediately after the attack started, we got up a message to the 6th Fleet that we were under attack by an unidentified aircraft. The USS America, USS Saratoga, launched aircraft to come to our assistance. Before those aircraft reached the horizon, they were recalled on orders from the White House. About half an hour or so later, they launched again, and again those aircraft were recalled while we were still under attack and calling for help. That in itself is a violation of Article 99 of the Uniform Code of Military Justice. The bottom line is we were attacked by unmarked aircraft. Our radios were jammed on U.S. Navy tactical and international maritime distress frequencies. Our life rafts were deliberately machine gunned in the water, ones we had dropped over the side in anticipation of abandoning ship, and we were abandoned under fire. The official Israeli position is they mistook us for a 40-year-old rusted out Egyptian tramp steamer called the Al-Khazir. Oh, they've apologized for the accidental attack. They're describing the attack, and then they're apologizing for their description of the attack. The thing that bothers us is how we were treated by the U.S. government, how we're continuing to be treated by the U.S. government.